I swear, if you only knew the whole story or cared like that, you see why this is emotionally derailing to want to dive into. Like, how do I really start with the mental placing of this venture after 5 years? Like, I've been rather successful again at doing this shit recently in Dragon Ball because I just stopped giving a fuck about it all in all. I just stopped caring. The community and the game both for ostracizing reasons around selfishness, ego whoring, and a lot of Hollywood hypocrisy activities from everyone I worked with through the lower, intermediate, and higher levels. One at the top level, but I don't need to worry about that shit. The community showcasing's biased sense of East Coast or North America representation has proven it doesn't want me around or want Icon Battle Circuit to be a bigger or household name because I'm not good enough to sit at the table of the elite or so-called elite for whom they deem worthy to be here visibly in a system already rigged from the start because I'm not from New York City or Chicago. The key starts with making the most of my time and accomplishing something that day or that sitting, and starting the budding of one said progress, from understanding setups to even recognizing how or if the opponent is punishing habits. Growing in the community competitively has evolved from a 2021-2022 crappy gatekeeping session where you're stuck fighting the same people until better players choose to notice you or you just happen to interact with them and get lucky on a set to play, to now a 2024 quiet time of sweating and casting shame where you have to test yourself all the time to know if you're ready for the next step by people telling you when you're ready or telling you if you're even worth it, thinking for you subconsciously and telling you that you don't know anything about what you're doing at any level you play, over helping it along wherever the fuck they're at. Then let's say you do make it and not break it. It's the same bias shit in the Reddit Discord of who can and cannot achieve a higher calling or a semi-professional gaming status or a role for better queue time or appreciation or visual acknowledgement and gain a better rep for yourself naturally based on who you know and not always what you know. There's easily a few characters through much of this scene that I know and I don't think they initially earned said statuses for a better clout standing, but apparently it pays to know the right people very early in the system after the huge, shitty Discord shift of power and Zephyr's fall from grace that changed the whole landscape of the DBFZ online community's image when the dust settled and we moved on past the grooming pedo scandals. Low-key approves me right there months later that it helps to suck the right dick extra good to have the glaze pay off for people speaking good about you when you haven't done shit for yourself to earn it or to get there. Then, the essence of competition itself is so polarizing between playing what you want and then also playing the meta to win that you just do whatever the hell you want to do, seeing as players will judge you anyways. Shit is going to judge shit because they're not like us type shit. Playing the meta one time in trial assessment, suddenly you're carry. Boom, you're trash. You can do better, but you're not, nor were you ever good. You're carried through online. Oh, but get this shit. But the trash ass next to me that I've been bullying most of the time, you're deeming a fully better, competent player than me because he's still learning and you want to help him. I reach out to get that help. There's a fee for me. You got to pay. You got to be cool. You got to be friendly. You got to be approachable. If I have as much influence on PlayStation as I supposedly do, that I'm told to sway thought or point of interest in change, then you'd know this from engaging with me, because I'm always in the public eye helping people or creating great energy with people or helping along opportunities for people. Like talking out your ass much? It's always the case of never being good enough. Rinse and repeat. It's the same shit every era. PSN or PC, both, it doesn't matter, because the community already has a set image. No matter how much good you do, you are always going to be the victim, because that's how you're labeled as. It doesn't matter who the fuck you are. Then we go overseas. All these small, spread out, but equally important scenes for like France or UK, Germany, Spain, Poland, and many more of our brothers and sisters across the waters achieving greatness. The players are welcoming, inviting, socially sound, hungry for the scene's revival after the EU regional fall-off a couple years ago back in 2022. Unbiased so far, and are great jokesters and conversationalists, actually. Many different matches I've been sitting there grinding, huffing, puffing, sweating, and laughing, both playing a lot of these monsters and hidden shadow bosses. I've been learning more about myself playing their pool of EU and European players in 1 month than months of varied matchmaking across North American servers now that we're integrated. Trying to learn from people, autopiloting reactions, but not telling me anything. And the few I can lock down point out mainly what's wrong, but never what to do better that's fine or already decent that I'm probably doing. Like what I've seen or felt through the years seeking the top or close to it. 6 separate times I fought their own in the EU at top level, or a surprise encounter, and I felt I did fine or okay. Like Kaimart, or Dragon Warrior, Vadect, Marshall, Giovanni, or Noka. Like, these are a lot of high-class players I'm aware of for the EU region of high-level or top-level activity and priority. Hell, I first met Noka at the World Tour edition of the Battle of Ningen Supremacy for European and UK last month. Noka's like one of the best EU players of France. He's the best Beerus of France. And I somehow was able to directly contest him twice. And I came close to beating him in the opening live stream bracket segment. It's the same man that even praised my team style choice, because no one's seen a base Goku out here at this level of play that commonly. It's a rare sight to see. Then there's Vedect. Met him live on the FDA's hosting of the Battle Supremacy for EU and played him in the exhibition and in tournament both. And I also played him for my general competence test for the Reddit Discord to challenge for my semi-professional role, to be qualified to be a semi-professional player a couple of months ago. Lost horribly in both. But I bounced right back into the fight from the earlier encounters to contest the latter battle on better footing, and I almost was able to take a game off of him. He's one of the best players in the whole country of UK. I wasn't able to beat him, but I came close one time out of one of those sittings to eventually doing it. Like the ultimate degen of UK himself, his royal crispiness, as he calls himself, even he likes my work some. Because it's not like everybody else. And that's why it's good, because it's rare. You're not sitting here trying to be a competitive sheep, copying what everybody else does, when you can just master your own craft and deal with the ups and downs of whatever the hell you're doing that's been working. And then I look back at these fuckboys in NA and these NA players and their points of interest for also helping growth. Like I look at Double L. Like, he's always productive for newer and returning faces and scenes and focus points. You got Cater, New York elitist, always productive for change and consistency. You got Cool Kid, a popular PvP player. Helpful, but our schedules don't really align like that for me to really sit and engage with him like that anymore. You got Enzim. He ignores helping people for the sake of content and spreading shit through clout. Faulty Things is a New York Hollywood elitist. Truly New York's finest. Like, he only helps out his own in New York. Or Coach. Like, I can feel like I never can reach him on a good day directly. Or KJ, also another elitist. Always a polite way of declining matches or 1v1 requests when I do want the level up from the best players I know, but you always keep finding a way to not want to play me. Get tired of that shit. Or scambi. He's very helpful, but our schedules no longer align since he moved between work and his kid, so I barely see him anymore. Zane, he's a grand blue player now that plays DBFZ on the side, so tips and tricks are a mute point. And then you got Pred, only helps his own, another New York elitist. You got Cloud, one of the top players that helps out when the lobbies were up. I want to say when his lobbies were up and he was doing the live matches on Dragon Ball as opposed to just doing ranked content was when he was really engaging without a fee to it, including or excluding Metafy. And then Nitro, another New York elitist. For a fee, he can help out and help with these fundamentals. Or he also helps his own in New York City. It's difficult to pin him down, or you don't pin him down at all. He rarely checks his DMs like that. Or you got Acoustics, another elitist, for a non-refundable fee will help you or speak to you about shit. And it's half-assed at that, big as that man is. And you got Kite, another one of the competitive elitists that only helps his own or those worthy of him talking to. You got to be worthy in order to talk in this fuckboy's space. I don't got time for that shit. And don't even speak to me about Akari's dumb black ass. I hate even mentioning his name in my presence. And then outside the very small percent, that's really the small percent out of those I mentioned that are like the higher ups and the point of interest here in Dragon Ball, is basically Double L and Cater that I feel are among the more socially involved players at high and top level that you can talk to. Everybody else, they have nothing to really give or offer to actual growth for the lesser known or lower clouded, quote unquote, focused players. Like peasant fuckery for the dum-dums. Again, it's a hoop jumping process to appease nobody important, nor the people that can apply real change to be a real figure for the people. Which, again, you don't matter. Clout matters. You matter if you're helping to glaze them, but not to blaze them. Most of them don't seek platform applications to help nurture the scene they're benefiting from. They just want to keep taking from it. Short of honestly labeling it as stealing from it, since you're not really trying to give back to the scene, but you want others to give back in your place. The newer system of representation implemented this year is vastly better than the old system, and it's still struggling. Like, the old system, it was just Damascus, maybe Tyrant, Bum, and Neo in place of Spooky Past that have the prime representation of Dragon Ball Fighters as core imagery, and I'm not going to be told otherwise on this shit because fuck you. It's been shoved in the consumer's face enough to be that viewing, and nothing else. And then, after I gave up full-time competition following Spooky's passing of the torch, I went the director and TO route fully instead of juggling them both in order to give back to my community at a better rate. Not the FGC, they can fuck themselves, but for my community, mine, Tax City. Tax City is who I put above the FGC. Those are my people, my followers, my friends, my family. The feeling of deceit and disappointment in the FGC was returned in full as I grew in the field prosperously and had literally passed a lot of the takers and organizers already here on their way out the door. And as I put the person, customer first, not the image of the scene first, you start to notice a vast difference of how service is reciprocated accordingly between what you're supposed to do and what you're actually doing. And you got the excess hypocrites lying their ass off through the years as a sexy truth. Hollywood listed TOs pulling the sympathy act hard and the following to get your business and not really your interest. You got the biased social puppetry and closeouts between talking to a community but not the newcomers. Or opening your doors to new players for their money but shutting out and or overcharging newer hosts on the scene in those same portals to suppress the competition very early on in the game, in the lifespan, for whatever that sitting or tenure. Oh, and then you also have fake heroes. Being the perfect villain is such a beautiful, untold story. Beautiful piece of shit. And I'm going to tell the stupid out here why that is. Select players already on the board right now don't care about the imagery. They only care about the control, the manipulation, the money, the power, the clout, no matter how great or pathetic it is. People that do care have to be in the shadows of people that don't care. That's how it works. Rarely does it shift for the better, impending social balance and inclusion down the chain of command. Over years of everything being a process to get paid for, or you're only helping people to get something in return, otherwise it's not worth the time to help the people. It's like a whole bunch of proper pathetic hypocrisy in the face of structural capitalism in the FGC. Like, if people are going to undergo backstabbing to get ahead like that, that's all you know how to survive, at least keep your set cogs in place that are already functioning, so it's easier to have a set communication over what I say goes type of ideology of sheep people logic. Like, keep the patheticness to a respectable amount of any kind. Unless it just leads to some dirty ass masturbation ritual for continual one track minded approval. It doesn't matter what you do to make a name for yourself or your original brand. It doesn't matter what you did or who you openly support in the community. What matters is clearly results, not the process. As much as you have to do the process, it's the results. And that they're due their return of whatever the fuck for caring about other people that they supposedly already do care about people. Simple ass shit they should be doing anyways that they proclaim so hypocritically. Then guess what? It's not about the results anymore. Now it's about the presentation. Then it's about the way you did the presentation, the way you went about it. There's always an excuse to bend the rules your way yet again because you can't do the shit by the book because it's too hard. It's just easier to cheat the system because fuck you. It's so easier to cheat the system because fuck you. It's forever a battle of who you know versus what you know. Both are used against you unless you were already set in one area before choosing to do anything. If you were already the it boy or the poster boy in the right circle, ready to be glazed, they're literally just going to take you up out of the audience or out the stands, wherever the hell you is, and then turn you into that person because you're one of them. Honestly, that's how I know it's a favoritism thing around the scene and not some shitty, oh, I forgot, or when's your next event, I might pull up type shit, giving excuses from a lot of the unmentionables in some long, excessive tour. Hell, you can know everything and damn near everybody in this scene, just like what I've done, as I continue to just be pushed out, ostracized, undermined commonly, thought less of by my own peers, and yet considered highly by non-North American players because of the same line of work in respect, and forced to be in people's shadows over resuming standing in my own light because I know too much and I am not favored by many of the younger people applying blunt nepotism with friends and pushing their bullshit narratives to feel important or wanted like you belong some damn where. A lot of that transcended in the new system, but not all of it, thank God. With this, it's better now because there's a structured system around advertising all brands active on the game circuit or community circuit, so everyone appropriately has a chance to be seen or heard or to be growing their platform or its involvement as they should. No lies, no filtering, no manipulation of people's inclusion for fake involvement, no selfishness, openly at least. It's just simple communications to help push others' projects for the scene so we all can grow. It's not just the one or two people, quote unquote bum or Neo, solely growing off the backs of other people suffering at the same fucking time. The siphoning bullshit has to stop. And so I circle back around to this. Why the fuck do I want to come back to this pissant video games community? Why? Why do I really want to do this shit? Now that I stopped giving a fuck, now suddenly I'm doing good at it. Why am I trying to waste time in such a pretty ass hellhole, as time has shown me time and time again through all the errors of the video game, despite the growing fog of division, that I'm not welcomed here? I'm seeking to grow bigger as a player, win an event so I can gain true respect for what I do, when the communities don't care about any of that shit or don't care about my well-being. They only care about when the next icon is or how much is in the prize pot. Players always take shit from you, yet deny you what you have the right to take after it's earned. Others is just given to them, but fuck you anyways. Cause privilege. What little accolades I do earn don't matter, cause you're not known for them, thus you have to be in the shadows of dinosaurs and the shitty-ass relevant players of the now wanting dick-stroking sessions, masturbating about bitches they're courting and the bitches they're praising through the scenes. I have more achievements than most of the hotshots they favor who don't barely have any accolades to their name because they're cool. Then try to talk to people despite being bluntly antisocial. They have game sense and they appeal to people when no, they don't. I'm seeking to spread out my brand and influence to give back to this scene with proper networking skills. But it's not reciprocated by the same people or at all because you're not popular. It doesn't matter. Your seniority and experience doesn't matter. Popularity matters. Helping out doesn't matter because you don't matter. You're not popular. And because you're trying to seek help and you're not popular, then people totally shut you out. They gain nothing from you, so by result, you don't get anything from them. You don't get their time, even if they come to your scene in order to try and steal from your scene or take from your shit. A self-made brand spread out to 7 different video games and 7 different lanes on a budget with Twitch lackings and interest roller coasters to be a part of or to be the core bloodstream of half those lanes, barely holding on myself to keep it all together like a mountain on my back by myself. Isn't enough of a struggle to warrant aid, but it's enough to piss in somebody's eye. I got you. Oh, but get this shit. So you can be a nobody out of nowhere from a common locality, drop money for an event you really don't have, and now people consider you a god. They consider you amazing or better than hosts that have been here doing this shit for your stupid ass and doing the service of raising money for events that you refuse to support on your time that you're benefiting from anyways. It's just so delicious. It's just so hot to see the beautiful garbage around the scene. Your fucking Brian Hakai's or your Calimax, Acoustics, Blackwing, Daniel, fucking Zephyr. Someone doesn't know half the shit they're doing and needs to learn this shit gradually on their own. But because they have pockets and not a personality, you'll help them at the drop of a dime. Then ask, oh, hey, do you need anything? Hey, are you okay? Do you need anything? I want to call, check in to see how you're doing. Like, you just can't get enough dick? Like, I want you to off yourself before talking to me ever again. It's like, seriously, do the air around us a favor instead of sucking it up breathing. But we all can't get what we want, as life shows us. Like, you'll be broke trying to keep a scene aloft, and more people here will always take it for granted than be thankful for what's here. Why? Because you don't matter. You conveniently never matter. It's enough for me to vomit with rage and disgust to have to be in the presence of players that blatantly steal from me, lied to me, tried to cheat me, belittle successes, and trying to cheat opportunity. You correct someone, there's an issue. You talk back to a named person or you make a game opinion or a tier list, there's a fake-ass problem because of an opinion versus a famous opinion, you peasant-ass person. Little do you know, they do that shit with their own because they really don't always respect each other's opinions like they feel they do. then there's the issue of never glazing the right person clearly. More people backstab you than talk to you face to face because they avoid confrontation. Just easier to be a bitch and save face. Looking back, hell, I still honestly regret working with Kelso 2 times because of what was supposed to boost both our stats and reach across online instead turned into a one-sided avenue talking to a dead server and deaf people, with him trying to take from me an outlet he doesn't even have control over anymore since he converted to PC. Instead of reviving activities consistently for console and PC, but can't because of work, respectfully, you just gradually appeal to my audience to persuade them to follow you. I'm not even trying to work together at that point, you're just working against me, predictable as it is. I've almost always resented Bum and Neo for being selectively hypocritical and greedy about views, collaborations, or bringing up people and seeking help when it's more using people than working with people. And because I pointed this out to their scenes and to the people across the masses little by little over the years, to those that care and need to know this shit, I've been ostracized more and more each year for being a truth teller because people don't handle the truth and can't handle the truth. They would rather live a fucking lie. To a person of named interest, that has to be from their circles for it to matter. If you're not from the Bronx or from New York, then time is money despite who you know or your own status. Starting at, what, $100 or some shit last I was quoted. $100 apparently just for someone to flash a logo in your face or a banner for 1 or 2 times and that's it. But hey, New Yorkers will be what they will be, building up their own to continue the crookedness, one snakehead at a time. I've given to them for years at a distance, and the two-faced activity was predictable in the means of always taking and talking and never giving back outside the content or their circles. It's just a fucking facade. The lying, cheating, trolling, backstabbing, casual two-face, smurf abuse, greed, money-hungry bullshit, being constantly ungrateful or entitled, the polarizing assholes, the lost pedophiles of the past, thankfully, and the hypocritical pussies of the present, sadly. These people just need to disappear because you don't know how to nurture people. You don't know how to collab in a healthier light. You don't know how to build up other people's and see the return because it was initially genuine and not underhanded or led to be deceitful by you or your interests. You don't know how to stop feeling owed and start paying it forward. You don't know how to talk to people. Don't know how to stop being a bitch ass. It's just been a common failure to communicate that has allowed a successful, complex corruption. We're taught better than this by the time we get on some fucking video game and engage with the sitting community. But hey, when you're young, who fucking cares? A lot of these FGC people or Gen Zs or personalities that try to change shit and do it hypocritically are just a fucking joke.
I would rather be the villain of my own story, be the asshole I was meant to be, and risk losing everything being honest with every dumb motherfucker I know right now, then choose to go back and associate with a lot of them in this scene just to be willingly backstabbed, cheated, and disappointed further, thinking the stupid ass will really do better and be better after all this time between me not hosting and my absence to take care of Rodimus. Like, am I really going to be that stupid to just go willingly associate with them again? No. I would rather just be an asshole. And I feel like that's the appropriate route. I mean, honestly, what do I have to lose at this point? If I was barely gaining anything, what do I actually have to lose? So I'm going to settle on this route for right now. And see where taking the anti-hero or flat-out villain approach will take me. And for the Dragon Ball community, fuck you. I'll see you soon. Peace.